Welcome to the 2004 NCAA Women's Final Four on ESPN. It's LSU against Tennessee in our first semifinal from New Orleans, a magical city with a reputation of making and breaking a team's fortunes.
You are not simply numbers, ranks, pawns, like lifeless face cards. What matters is that you are here. The cards pick up the vibes, but you make your destiny happen.
I put a spell on you, 'cause you're mine.
The Empress.
When you come to a Final Four, you shouldn't be happy just to be here. You want to take it all in, but you want to leave it all on the court. Focus on execution and not on expectations.
Strengths.
You never know who's going to be a superstar that day. You can't key on one person, and I think that's the beauty of it.
Play Tennessee basketball and everything else to take care of yourself.
The Wheel of Fortune.
They're making me look good just in terms of their sheer determination to win.
Overcome so much, and this is the year, seems to be, for our university.
Players lost, injuries, coach leaving the bench because of illness.
Motivation is really not a key. I mean, we're where we dream to be. Watch out. Don't underestimate us.
It does not matter what number you have been assigned. Your fate is in the cards, and your card has yet to be turned.
The host city for the 2004 Women's National Championship. Tonight, the semifinals from the New Orleans Arena. The opening matchup features a pair of longtime SEC rivals. The number four seed, the Lady Tigers of LSU, against the Lady Vols of Tennessee, the only top seed left in the tournament. Later tonight, the second semifinal match is Minnesota, the only number seven seed ever to reach the Final Four out of a 64-team field, against the two-time defending champion, UConn Huskies. LSU has been carried in this tournament by Simone Augustus, averaging more than 26 points a game during the NCAAs, while Tennessee's Tasha Butts has scored the winning points in back-to-back games. Good evening, everybody. I'm Mike Patrick, along with Ann Myers. It's great to have you with us. In this year's Final Four, you have the perennial powers of Tennessee and UConn, but you also have two teams who have never been here before, LSU and Minnesota.
Well, certainly, Mike, people are familiar with Connecticut and Tennessee and their coaches, Gino Auriemma and Pat Summitt. Between the two of them, they've been to 23 Final Fours and have won 10 championships. Now, they're looking for another one, but you've got those first-timers in LSU and Minnesota. They are not starry-eyed. It's a classic matchup of David against Goliath, and like the paper said, history versus mystery.
Absolutely. We're looking forward to every second of it. Mark Jones and Doris Burke will be working the sidelines for us. Let's start with Doris.
Mike, when LSU departed the team's hotel just blocks from the arena, they did so without the architect of their basketball program. A case of acute bronchitis has sidelined head coach Sue Gunter, whose career spans 40 years and includes over 700 wins. She has turned the program into the capable hands of Pokey Chapman, who has gone 14-4 and led this team to the program's first ever Final Four. Sue Gunter watches this game from the team's hotel, but I guarantee you this, she is not far from the hearts and minds of the LSU players and coaches. For more on Tennessee, let's go to Mark Jones.
You know, Doris, no player on the Tennessee roster has raised the level of their play more in the postseason than Tasha Butts. She scored the game winner for the Lady Vols in the last two consecutive games against Baylor and Stanford in the regional final. But the interesting story about her burgeoning leadership skills goes back to a recent conversation she had with a former teammate and former All-American, Carol Lawson, who told her, and I quote, "You can't be afraid, Tasha, to stand alone and tell your teammates what they don't want to hear." Well, so far, Butts has done just that, and the only feelings that are getting hurt are the opponents, Mike Patrick. Back to you.
All right, thank you, Mark. And here's the Lady Vols lineup with Butts and Solman in the backcourt. Davis and Eli, the forwards, and Robinson is the center. In her 30th year at Tennessee, Pat Summitt has reached her 15th Final Four in pursuit of a record 7th national championship. It's a three-guard lineup for LSU. Johnson, Hodges, and Augustus, with Jones and Willis up front. These two teams met once earlier this year, and Tennessee handled LSU easily in that game. By the way, this game also available at ESPN High Definition. And if you haven't seen it, you ought to take a look. It is unbelievable. Tennessee comes in 30-3. LSU 27-7. And they have split the last four meetings that they have played over the last couple of years.
We really look for an up and down game. Both these teams play man to man. They're aggressive. They know each other so well, playing in the SEC. Tennessee leads the series 31-38.
Robinson will jump center against Augustus. Tennessee in the home white as the higher seed. And Tennessee controls the opening tip.
Now also, the last time these two teams met, it was at Tennessee, and it was senior night. There was a lot of emotion by this Tennessee team, but again, this is a new venue in the Final Four.
Clutch, the pass to Zolman. Now they go inside. The shot from Eli is blocked. And here come the Lady Tigers with their first possession. Keep an eye on Johnson. She is a great penetrator, basket, and the foul.
One thing Pokey Chapman told me before the game is that we're going to come out, be aggressive on the offensive end and the defensive end. When we can do it on the defensive end, come up with blocks like that, they are going to run, they're going to attack, and they're going to try and get to the free throw line as much as they can today.
The foul was on LaToya Davis, probably Tennessee's best defensive player, who combined with Butts to hold Augustus to a season-low 12 points in the first meeting. And Augustus has just been on fire in the NCAA tournament, averaging over 26 points a game.
Well, you talk about LaToya Davis. She started after Lori Moore went down against Duke. And Pat Summitt challenged her, and she has really made a difference in this lineup for them.
Zolman, very good outside shooter. Davis cut off at the baseline. Back to Eli. Only two on the shot clock. And Shira Eli has to fire and misses. Tillis with the rebound for the Lady Tigers. And here is Tamika Johnson.
The Tennessee, Mike, is so good at dominating the boards. They out-rebounded LSU 44-28. And LSU going inside like that, they're going to get easy shots. In the shoot-around today, LSU said, look, we're going to make the big players shoot from the outside. We don't want them to get inside so we can get those rebounds.
Well, Wendellin Jones got inside for LSU, and LSU is up 5-0. Zolman can't penetrate.
LSU really doing a fine job as far as not letting that dribble penetration in the lane. There
now Butts gets inside but missed the shot badly. The foul was good in the basket.
And this will be dictating the game, I think. We talk about the rebounding, that second and third opportunity. That's where Tennessee is so good, Mike. If they miss that shot, they are crashing the boards. They're so aggressive, and that's where they score on those second and third opportunities.
Tennessee comes into the game with a 6.5 rebounding margin advantage over its opponents all year. LSU, less than 2. And Butts, who's an 81% free throw shooter, misses a chance at a three-point play.
And she made those two clutch shots. I think, you know, the two free throws against Baylor and the clutch shot against Stanford.
Absolutely.
To get them here to the Final Four.
Otherwise, they don't get past a round of 16.
A great matchup with Butts on Augustus. Augustus averaging 29 points the last two games.
He's got that line drive shot, can't hit it. Zolman kicks it ahead. Davis running, had it knocked out of her hands and out of bounds by Willis. And off of her to LSU.
Wendellin Jones, the 6'1 sophomore, coming up with another block. Great drive by Tennessee. You see Davis attacking the basket. Both teams will do that this whole game. It's really going to be a game of tempo. Who's going to get the transition? Who's going to be able to score in the half-court game?
LSU right now looking a little more comfortable in its offense than Tennessee has been.
LSU runs that motion offense, and they say you can't just key in on Simone Augustus. There's other scorers on this team, and other players have stepped up.
Hodges had it blocked, got it back, and missed.
Well, Tennessee is a team offensively. They like to go inside. Ashley Robinson doesn't score on the block that much. They like to clear it out for Shira Eli and Butch to get shots. But they'll score, as we said, off those second and third opportunities.
Nine on the shot clock. Zolman, who has a tough time getting her own shot, but has a great touch when she does, hits this and cuts the lead to one.
That was just really a nice curl off that staggered pick down low. There were two players down low sending picks for her, and the defense got caught behind.
Kelly Willis, the junior, throws it past to Mika Johnson. Tennessee, 4-0, of course, in the tournament. Really not challenged until they got against Baylor, and that late whistle with 0.2 seconds left gave them the opportunity to win that ball game, and then they eliminated Stanford.
A lot of controversy on that call, whether it was or not a foul. Some people say yes, some people say no, but it stood, and Tasha Butts did a great job knocking down the free throw.
Well, the timing certainly made it stand out, and Shira Eli with a great drive, but she couldn't finish.
We saw Ashley Robinson get those long arms in there, couldn't grab it. Her right arm is taped. She hyperextended it. It's just sore. It doesn't bother her.
Boy, Davis doing a nice job denying the ball to Tamika Johnson, who only needs 6 assists to break the all-time NCAA single tournament record for assists. She is averaging a double-double in this tournament, 10.5 assists a game. It's remarkable. She has yet to get one this evening.
And that's up to her teammates.
Hodges being dogged by Zolman, and now a steal for Tennessee. Good defense again by Davis, and that's what they expect from her. Zolman, excellent outside shooter, missed that Tillis with a rebound.
Zolman is struggling in the tournament from her long-range shot.
LSU on the run, offensive foul. Danica Hodges picks up her first personal.
Let's party New Orleans, guys.
How inspiring can a minivan be? Can it give you seats when you need them? And space when you don't? Yes. Can it take a mountain of stuff and make it disappear? With exclusive Stow-N-Go seating and storage? Absolutely. Introducing the all-new Chrysler Town & Country, starting at $20,995. Chrysler. Inspiration comes standard.
Here we go. Steal. Down the middle. 101. Bang!
Did you see what I see? Because I saw a robber.
Does anybody want a coke?
Yeah.
Hey, you crazy, man? That's Corinthian leather. And use the footstool to get to the refrigerator. I'm running all over y'all like a treadmill.
Oh,
I am the greatest.
I'm the greatest.
Can't stop it. It's bad.
That's
hot. I'm telling you, I'm just super nice in it, you know? That's all. When you nice, right?
Oh.
That's like all that talk.
If you want to get a jump on spring, you can. And if you want to do it now and pay for it later, you can. Right now at the Home Depot and Expo Design Center, you'll get no payments and no interest for 12 months on everything in the store. Just use your consumer credit card. Or if you don't have one, open a new credit card account and you'll get 10% off your first purchase store-wide. You can save up to $200. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Welcome to the wireless age. Got your HP Pavilion ZT3280 notebook PC featuring Intel Centrino mobile technology. Your HP camera and wireless printer. Setting it up was easy, right, Techno Boy? Because you went to CompUSA for that state-of-the-art HP engineering. Then CompUSA came over, set it up, and trained you for free. Who else gives you so much attention? CompUSA. Unmatched.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship is brought to you by Chrysler. Inspiration comes standard.
18,211 on hand here in New Orleans to see semifinal number one of the women's Final Four at the New Orleans Arena. And it's an early one-point lead for LSU.
Well, Tennessee only shooting 25%, 2 of 8, but they're getting the shots up. But LSU, 7 rebounds to 3.
And good defense causes another turnover, trying to get down to Lane Robinson, couldn't do it. Here's the road to the Final Four, and the big surprise, the staggering upset by 16 points over number one Texas, repaying the favor from a year ago, and then they beat Georgia to make the Final Four.
A lot of people felt that LSU had their best team last year and lost to Texas in the Elite Eight to send Texas to the Final Four.
Willis holds the ball outside. Shot clock winds its way down to 9.
And Augustus has only had one shot at the basket. They're doing a great job, Tennessee, defensively on it.
Johnson, good penetration, but she got in too deep. And Tamika Johnson picks up her first personal on a charge.
And Tennessee has made the adjustment early defensively. They're getting good position. They're sliding over and helping out. And Pat Summitt says this has been a team ruled by committee, especially when Lori Moore went out. This is a team that went over to Greece without Lori Moore, who played on the Pan Am team. They didn't have it, so other people had to step up in different positions.
And they have really had point guard by committee. They have had leading scorer by committee. And this is really a Tennessee team that is void of the usual star players that Pat Summitt has had.
Well, really,
and you have to think it's one of the best coaching jobs she's ever done.
Well, she was named Naismith Coach of the Year, and Shira Eli was a Kodak All-American this year.
Davis out of the corner. LaToya Davis only averages 5 points a game. Anything they get from her offensively is a bonus.
And she's averaging 11, though, in the playoffs.
Yes, she is. Augustus missed badly. The rebound went to Wendell and Jones, and she draws a foul. Check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, Mike, 3 years ago when Pat Summitt was racking up a ton of frequent flyer miles between Baton Rouge and Knoxville, she envisioned a homecoming for Simone Augustus here at the Final Four in New Orleans, but as a Lady Vol, she saw her play her last high school game, thought she was the best offensive player she had ever seen. That included Shamika Holtzclaw and Tamika Catchings, but two things played into the decision for Simone Augustus. Number one, she wanted to play for Sue Gunter. Number two, she was a fashion design major. LSU had that program. And the rest, as they say, guys, is history. They are here in New Orleans.
And she still has a lot of history to write for this club.
Oh, she will. And Doris, remember when she went to announce her press conference, she wore an orange shirt with an orange hat to fool everybody. But she had called Pat Summitt the night before to let her know she wasn't coming.
Must have scared the LSU people to death. Miss outside by Butts. Here comes Johnson on the run. Hodges, that was partially blocked. Augustus, offensive rebound and a great step through to get by Davis.
Simone Augustus this summer played for Jim Foster on the USA Young Women's team, and he had to talk to the USA committee, Mike, to convince them to take Simone Augustus. She was voted the female MVP for the United States.
Collision with Eli inside, and now there's going to be a foul on Tennessee going for the loose ball rebound.
He knew how good Simone Augustus was. Look at those long arms. Just a great reach. Has an instinct of where the ball is going to be. And that's what makes a great player, too. You're not always going to get the ball in the offense. And she always makes herself available to where the ball is going to be.
Ashley Robinson picked up that foul. And Sydney Spencer, number one, will check in for the first time. And LSU tonight, only 3 field goals and 4 turnovers early. And this is a team that is 6th in the nation in committing turnovers, only 13-3 a game. They can't continue at this pace. Wide open jump shot for Tilly Willis, who couldn't hit it.
Well, and that's the key right now for LSU. They've got to have other players hit the open shots. Tennessee is going to sag off on Tamika Johnson and Simone Augustus, and Hodges are the 3 scorers. The other two for LSU, they've got to step up.
And they do not shoot well as a team. Shot clock at 10 for Shira Eli to Spencer. This is Zolman. Nice drive by Shauna Zolman. Couldn't hit the shot, and Augustus with a rebound.
A tough break. She had a wide open lane.
Shalonda Hostin into the game for the first time. Her shot won't go, but she draws another foul. And it's the second on Shira Eli.
And I think that's a good shot by Hostin. Tough call on Eli, but in the sense that LSU, they've got to come up and hit those jumpers. They've got to stop and pop because Tennessee has already taken two charges on them, and they're going to stop that drive.
Hostin, a sophomore out of Miami, hits the first free throw. She'll get another, and the lead grows to three for LSU.
Yeah, she missed all year last year, June 15th, 2002. She had a daughter, Aishita, and she was so upset that she had to walk away from her scholarship, and Sue Gunner came back to her and said, hey, guess what? You know, you work and get your academics, you got your scholarship back. And she got herself back in shape.
It's a big load for a young lady to carry, to be a mother, an athlete.
She got married.
And a wife, and concentrate on academics. That's going to be a foul on Spencer, who did a world-class rideout job on the rebound and was called for it, although Pat Summitt would disagree. But Sydney Spencer just about took Wendell and Jones into the cheap seats. Augustus.
Bob Starkey said this morning that Schumacher, we've got to have that Texas mindset. This LSU team just really destroyed Texas as far as any kind of rebounding situation. They've got to come out with that mindset against Tennessee, but two different teams.
Zolman got caught up in the air and had to kick it back outside. But Augustus is on her. Zolman had the shot blocked by Hostin. Great step out defense by the sophomore.
That's three blocks in this first half by this LSU team.
They are very athletic, and they can match Tennessee stride for stride.
And Butts is just shadowing Augustus. I mean, she's fronting her. She's all over. She doesn't really see where the ball is all the time. She just knows where number 33 is.
Good idea. Augustus just been destroying people. Great entry pass by Johnson, and Willis gets her first bucket. The lead's up to five.
But that's what happens in that motion offense. Simone Augustus clears out, leaves the lane wide open.
Great start for the Lady Tigers. 11:48 to go, first half. They have nearly doubled up Tennessee. It's 11-6. And Ann, I always look at the start of a ball game for a team that you would think would be the underdog, LSU, having been beaten so badly by Tennessee in the first match. But maybe the energy is coming from all these LSU folks who were able to get tickets and make the drive down 80 miles from Baton Rouge.
Well, a lot of people felt that there would be a lot of pressure on LSU because this is, they feel, the fans, a home court advantage for them. But there's a lot of stress because they're trying to get tickets for their family and their friends.
Right.
Everybody's calling them. But I tell you, Sue Gunner and her coaches, Pokey Chapman and Bob Starkey, Carlin Berry on the bench, they've done a tremendous job preparing them all season long.
Mark Jones is with us, of course. Let's check in with him right now.
Guys, Tennessee could really use Lori Moore's energy right now. There she is on the bench, and she underwent surgery recently after blowing out her ACL back on January the 24th. She has now taken on kind of the unofficial role as an assistant coach, going so far as to have her name written on the back of her chair like the other assistant coaches. But during that last time out, she does what she's been typically doing recently, giving out equal parts of advice and criticism to her teammates, especially with Tasha Butts during that last break. Back to you, Mike.
All right, Mark, and you got to have that to win a national championship. LSU on top of Tennessee by five.
Bacardi Silver Razz. Premium malt beverage. 5% alcohol by volume. All the passion of raspberry. Your night just got more interesting.
How much inspiration can you fit in a small car? Can you make it fun for two? Or four? Yes. Will 220 horses inspire it to gallop? Absolutely. Can it have more than enough room for her? Him? Them? Yes. Chrysler PT Cruiser, starting at $19,995. Chrysler, inspiration comes standard.
Insurance, loans, retirement. AIG.
We know money.
You know the feeling. Every guy's had it. You're unbeatable. Unstoppable. You got that walking on water feeling. You look, they smile. You win, they go home. Gillette. It's the feeling you get every day with the world's best shave, Mach 3 Turbo. It's like having an angel by your side. Every move is smooth. Every word is cool. I never want to lose that feeling. Gillette. The best of me.
Pat Summitt talking to her ball club during the timeout, down five early. And she is obviously not pleased with the early effort.
But this is the team that knows how to come back. They've got five players with six fouls, Shara Eli with two. And so the fouls have kind of slowed them down a little bit. But this is a team that has come from behind and won games. This is very early in the game.
They've been down 10 times this year and come from behind to win.
Now Sydney Spencer is on Simone Augustus. Very physical player against Simone Augustus.
Augustus hasn't had much luck getting the ball.
And now they switch off with Latoya Davis. This is exactly what they did to Nicole Powell at Stanford.
Turnaround jump shot rolls over the rim for Jones, and Tennessee's been getting killed on the boards early. And that's a big bonus for LSU. Davis short on the jumper, got her own rebound. Goes inside, lost the ball, the follow goes.
And that's that second opportunity and hustle play by Tennessee. Simone Augustus did a good job defensively, initially on Latoya Davis to give her the shot, but then forgot to block out.
11-8, the lead cut to three. Here goes Johnson off balance and hurt again. Tamika Johnson, and she is fearless.
And she hit her thigh or something. She's wincing coming out of there, but she's so great getting inside that lane.
Last year, she had a broken orbital bone that didn't keep her out of there. Brittany Jackson with a three, rattles out on her, and the rebound again to Willis, who's had four caroms in the first half.
Well, Tennessee is going to have to make some adjustments on the offense as far as going to the offensive glass. The thing is, what you do is you sacrifice not only getting that second and third opportunity, but if LSU were to get the rebound, then you're sacrificing the fast break opportunity for the Tiger.
Boy, and Tamika Johnson is really hurt. Augustus with a tough runner. Tamika Johnson can barely get up and down the court right now.
She didn't want to come out. Pokey Chapman's got some subs down there. Danica Hodges will take over at that point guard position, and it's a different transition when she's at that guard.
Jackson kicks it back outside. Now two good shooters, Jackson and Zolman, in the lineup.
When Hodges comes in and plays that point, Mike, she calms things down a little bit. Doesn't push it quite as much as Tamika Johnson does.
That's a travel on Jackson as the shot clock was under 10. 9:31 to go, first half. The lead is 7. And Tamika Johnson is going to get an escort to the end of the bench. Johnson, who is a brilliant story, having lost her first year of eligibility with this club as a partial qualifier, but her grades have been great throughout her career. She's a senior this year. She gets a year of eligibility, and she'll come back next year for her second senior year.
And LSU's got some great freshmen coming in.
Augustus with a miss on a runner, and she draws the attention wherever she goes. Davis on the run, reach in, foul will be on Hostin.
You can see Tennessee, both these teams like to push it up the floor, Mike. And Tamika Johnson in pain right now.
Boy, she's hurting.
And this is a tough kid. I've seen her play sick. I've seen her play, as you said, with her eye last year. Ankle injuries.
Now we've got a holding foul before the inbounds. That's going to be on Hostin. So she's picked up two in literally 1 second. No time ran off the clock there.
Yeah, a foul situation is always critical as far as how coaches are going to get their kids in, who's in foul trouble. That's why the benches are going to play such a big part in this game, because of the way the whistles are going.
Tasha Butts gets it to Davis. Baseline drive and got it. 15-10. And now it's up to Danica Hodges, whose twin sister Ranika would have been on this national Final Four team, but she transferred to Florida State last year.
Played 3 years on this team, and Danica was number four, Ranika was number five.
Augustus short on the three-point attempt. Tennessee with numbers, Butts in the middle. Robinson, she's mugged inside. Ashley Robinson can't hit the shot, but will draw the foul. Trainell Clavel picks up the personal foul. This is the first national semifinal in the women's tournament, 18,211 at the New Orleans Arena. Glad you could join us for this. 8.5 minutes to go, first half. And it's a 5-point lead. And Ashley Robinson is the one place she does not want to be. A 41.8% free throw shooter. And here's the offensive comparison so far. Neither team shooting very well after some recent misses. And there's the Tamika Johnson. They're trying to stretch her out a little bit. And Robinson, the 6'5 center, missed them both.
Well, Ashley Robinson, that shooter on today, Pat Summitt, was watching over her about watching her make her free throws, and she was making her free throws at practice. It's like Shaquille O'Neal. He makes them practice all the time. Game time situation, a lot of different story.
Somehow the motion tends to change a little bit. The rim gets a little tighter.
Oh, nice back door, and they miss it.
Willis about 22 feet away from the basket. Didn't have a good look at it. Clavel, shot clock goes down to zero. That's a shot clock violation. Clavel had the ball out high, and Hodges, knowing Clavel wasn't going to shoot it from there, had to come out and get it from her, and they turn it over. 7:58 to go in the half. The lead still 5.
How much inspiration can you fit in a small car? Can you make it fun for 2? Or 4? Yes. Will 220 horses inspire it to gallop? Absolutely. Can it have more than enough room for her? Him? Them? Yes. Chrysler PT Cruiser, starting at $19,995. Chrysler, inspiration comes standard.
My ball. Nance, the top of the key. Staring King James down.
Back up, man. Up, a little rough.
Oh, yeah. Woo! You following me. All right, look, I'm gonna shoot free throw, okay? Okay, get back, man. Get on the line, all right? Free throws. All right? Here we go. Ah, yes.
That's a Cavs jersey you're wearing. Don't give up.
I heard about Avlamil, but it was safe and natural.
Introducing Avlamil, the non-prescription once-daily supplement made just for women.
So I tried it. That's when I started feeling intimate again.
The ingredients in Avlamil have been shown to enhance libido and help maintain hormonal balance.
I had desire, energy. I had passion. This is how I really am. I'm back to being me.
Now you can receive a free 30-day sample cycle. Just call or go online today. At some point in their lives, many women experience a decrease in libido due to stress, childbirth, menopause, or medications. Today, women of all ages are discovering Avlamil, the gentle, non-prescription, once-daily supplement made just for women. The ingredients in Avlamil have been shown to enhance libido, maintain hormonal balance, and promote a healthier, more energetic love life. Now, you can receive a free 30-day sample cycle. Free samples are only available for a short time, so call or go online today.
LSU with the first half lead over Tennessee, 7:58 to go in the half. Let's get an update on Tamika Johnson. Here's Doris Burke.
Well, Mike, Tamika Johnson on this dribble drive to the hoop suffered a thigh contusion, but she has checked back into the basketball game. She is available for the remainder of the half.
All right, thanks, Doris. That's good news for the Lady Tigers as their all-time assist leader, single season and career, is back on the court, and they're going to need her to play, although she's still limping. 6 out of 16 so far for LSU. Only 5 out of 17 for Tennessee. They have not hit a free throw or a three-point shot. Good runner there by Jackson.
And before that shot, the Lady Vols were shooting under 30%.
Johnson looks like she's slowed a little bit after that injury rest.
Both teams have done a pretty good job taking care of the basketball. 5 turnovers for LSU and 3 for Tennessee.
Did a pretty good job of spreading the court and isolating Augustus that time against Taisha Fluker, but she couldn't hit the wide open jump shot.
Well, Augustus is going to get her shots, and she gets a lot of shots in this NCAA tournament. But now she's got to get hot. She's got to want the ball. She's got to take charge. And in that motion offense, she'll get the ball.
Good entry pass to Fluker, and she banks it home against Clavel. The lead's been cut to one.
Well, you can't go for those steals. Clavel, the freshman, has got to stay in between Fluker and the basket. Fluker in the game, she's got a little bit more size, and as far as Robinson's a little taller.
Johnson against the double team. She makes more contact and draws another personal foul.
Well, Tamika Johnson just got lost amongst white jerseys, but there you see the nice pass by Brittany Jackson, and the turnaround by Fluker gives herself enough angle to use the backboard. That's a great shot.
Latoya Davis just picked up her second personal foul. It means two Tennessee starters with two, and this will be the bonus for Tamika Johnson, an 80.5% free throw shooter, fifth in the Southeastern Conference this year.
Well, both coaches are really going to have a chess game, I think, in the second half, depending on how many more fouls are called. There's 6:42 left to go in the game because a lot of players are on the bench. They play a lot of minutes.
That's right. Johnson, the hometown girl from New Orleans, has 7 points in the first half and noticeably limping as she comes back down court, grimacing actually with every step.
And 5 players on this LSU team from the New Orleans area.
Spencer, the good-looking freshman, can't hit that shot, gets her own rebound. Goes baseline, gets it back again, and is fouled. Spencer is a good-looking prospect out of Hoover, Alabama. Tomorrow night, join Chris Fowler, Dick Vitale, Digger Phelps, Jay Billis with Andy Katz, Steve Lavin, and Brad Daugherty on a special edition of College Game Night presented by Audi, live from the Final Four in San Antonio. All the latest news and a breakdown of the championship game at 7:30 Eastern on ESPN, all part of a week of madness presented by Harley-Davidson on ESPN.
You know, Pat Summitt bringing Sidney Spencer, the 6'3 freshman, and very versatile, can hit the outside shot, put the ball on the floor. She's goofy as all get out, and she keeps the team loose. Coming in, her nickname was Big Show, but they re-nicknamed her Money.
Tennessee backed it within one. Johnson controls the ball so well. That time she lost it on the way in. Now will they say it was touched by Tennessee? They do.
Again, you look at Johnson's size at 5'3". She is under control, but when you're that size, I think you're so low to the ground, you have such great balance, and you create that contact because it's so funny, Mike. Teams are still trying to block a shot, and they don't have to leave the ground because everybody's over 6 foot, and yet they're jumping up in the air,
yep.
And she creates that foul by making them jump to block a shot.
She is wonderful to watch. Made the all-tournament team in the West region where they won it there. And has a great connection with Poker Chapman. Hodges gets her first point. Another New Orleans native.
All SEC, Simone Augustus. And Tamika Johnson, Kodak All-American, Simone Augustus.
The lead is 2. LSU with a chance to tie, or Tennessee with a chance to tie. We'll take the lead with a 3, and we're under 6 minutes to go in the half. Jackson with Augustus on her. Butts.
Oh, nice screen.
Very quick.
Tasha Butts, her versatility as far as playing the point guard position has helped her game so much. She's got so much confidence.
She told us last year she sat down and wrote a schedule to improve her game because the first 2 years at Tennessee had not gone the way she wanted. The last two certainly have. Johnson, oh, great dish to Clavel. Her second assist. She's averaging 10.5 at the tournament.
Wow. That's all you can say is wow. And I love a team that will score off the pass rather than the dribble. I know you've got to have a player that can break down the defense with their ability to handle the ball on the floor, but there's nothing like scoring off the pass.
Spencer with a miss. Nice block out by Augustus.
You know that's my UCLA upbringing.
Yes, it is. And that's not a bad heritage either. Clavel had the shot rejected, but a foul.
Good ball movement, and Johnson's penetration again.
It's very difficult to stop. You see the defense rotate over, and Pat Summitt has talked about how good this defense of her team has played because they're willing to help each other out. But that time, again, with Johnson up in the air, she creates so many situations that it's difficult for a defensive team to figure out what she's doing. She makes a great pass.
Spencer goes out for Tennessee, and Ashley Robinson is back in.
Well, free throws down the stretch are going to be so important in this game.
Clavel, a 44% shooter. And if it comes down to Clavel and Robinson shooting free throws, the score might never change. They just struggle mightily when they go to the line. That one's partially blocked by Augustus. Retrieved by Robinson. Should give it back to Zolman.
Well, LSU has really been deceptive on the defensive end. They sag back, and those long arms are able to get pieces of that ball.
Butts fires quickly, but short.
Well, LSU's got such a good transition game. Again, it's not quite as quick right now. Both teams a little fatigued.
Willis. Now this is Hodges. Augustus got a screen. She'll take a 17-footer. She was fouled on the shot.
Well, Pat Summitt has gone with her two big players, Fluker and Robinson, both at 6'5 in the game. And Augustus, with her quickness, you saw Tilly Willis setting the screen, going down for Simone Augustus. And Robinson, who guarded Nicole Powell at times against Stanford, has great range, but Augustus using her balance and creating the foul.
Augustus, second in the nation in free throw shooting this year, 89-9, only because Shauna Zolman for Tennessee is now under the minimum to qualify for the National League. She was number one.
And I spent some time with Sue Gunner yesterday. She told me a great story that Simone Augustus was practicing her free throws, and she's so good. And Bob Starkey, the assistant, walked by and said, "What are you doing?" She said, "Well, I'm practicing my free throws." He said, "Why? You never get there." She only averages about three free throws, and that's one thing they want to instill in her, to be more aggressive.
But she makes them all. 3:59 to go in the half. LSU by four.
Where would we be if we always did things the way they were done before? Where would we be if everyone followed and no one led?
I'm never ever gonna get it all. I'm never ever gonna get it
The new dual action infusion from Spalding. Air when you need it, less when you don't.
Whoa. Digital widescreen high definition TVs with digital auto convergence and HD component video inputs. 65-inch widescreen display, translucent OSD, dual tuner, picture-in-picture, plus high-speed velocity scan modulation. Ooh. Don't touch.
Hey, guys, check out the game in high def.
Sweet.
Thousands of possibilities. Get yours. Best Buy.
LSU continues to hold the lead over Tennessee, 22-18. Right now, we check in with Mark Jones. Mark.
Head coach Pat Summitt very adamant about her huddle. A lot of fire and brimstone inside that huddle. Guys, defensively, very aware about her players getting over those flare screens on the wings. And she was demanding and saying, we want no more fouls until the half. Offensively now, no more quick shots. That was her demand. Doris Burke, what do you have?
Well, the LSU coaching staff wants to get Simone Augustus involved in some early ball screens, hoping for the switch from the post player so she can attack off the dribble. Mike,
She's only had two field goals in this game, but does have 6 points in a low-scoring first half.
Well, one of the things, too, that the Tennessee coach is very aware as far as their free throws are concerned, they are only 2 of 5, where LSU's gotten line 8 of 13.
Another steal for the Lady Tigers. This is Augustus in the open court. She's got Tasha Butts all over her and can't get the shot.
It shows you the ability in this first half, how the Tigers have been more aggressive, getting in the lane, getting themselves close to the basket to draw some fouls.
Johnson picked up her dribble, gets the pass inside. Willis can't hit the shot, and the rebound to Butts.
Neither team really shooting the ball well, but both teams taking care of the basketball.
LSU continues to hold a rebounding edge, which you would not expect against a bigger and at times more physical Tennessee team.
And this is a great matchup, I think, for Tennessee. I think Shauna Zolman's got to do a better job attacking Tamika Johnson. She's hurt. She's limping.
Yes, she is.
You think that you would try and test her lateral movement, but Tennessee has not done that.
That was Robinson missing everything at the Tennessee end. We're down to 227. They continue to try to run Augustus off of as many screens as possible. This is Hodges against Jackson. Can't get inside. Now Augustus with a runner. Won't go. And this one's knocked out of bounds and off of Crystal White of LSU out to Tennessee.
You know, and saying that, too, about the injury to Johnson right now, sometimes when you got a gutty player like that, you play smarter, too.
In the first meeting, Tennessee shot 56%. That was at home. Tonight, they're only shooting 31. But this is a better LSU team than the last time they met during the regular season. They have proven that in the playoffs.
They were at home, and plus it was senior night for three of these seniors, so there was a lot of emotion going on.
And the LSU bench explodes as Tamika Johnson is called for a blocking foul, her second, and right in front of the LSU bench, they thought it was a charge.
Well, Butts very quick. She's moving, but she looks like she's got position.
You can be moving, can't you?
That's right. That's right. And again, sometimes when you play those smaller players, they get a better position because the center of gravity is so much lower.
Butts hits the free throw. She'll get another. Tasha Butts has 5, and the lead is cut to 3. Spencer will come back in the ball game. She is number 1 for Pat Summit's Lady Vols. And they'll get Dominique Redding out of the ball game. She was in briefly. Only 9 players on the roster for Tennessee. After Lori Moore was hurt earlier in the year, Courtney McDaniel dropped off the team because of medical reasons, so down to 9.
Well, LSU's had some players that have been injured.
Sometimes it's a matter of survival. Nice entry pass from Augustus to White, and White is fouled as Jackson came over and tried to give her some help. Coming up on the Singular Halftime Report, we'll talk to Minnesota coach Pam Borton, whose team is standing by. Reese Nell and Stacy will have all the details of this first half for you. White out of Mount Clemens, Michigan. Misses the free throw.
You know, this Tennessee team lost in the semifinals in the SEC tournament in overtime against Georgia. And Andy Landers did a tremendous job with his team this year. And then they lost to this Sioux Gunners LSU team. But Pat Summitt said, you know, they were on the bus. She watched 3 hours of film. And the players really kind of took control. The players really redefined their roles. And Tasha Butts has really stepped up to the plate. On that last foul, Tasha Butts is in her teammate's face. And as Mark Jones alluded to in the first beginning of this game, that Carol Lawson said, you've got to take charge. You're the leader now.
LSU has really shared the wealth. They have 8 players in the scorebook here in the first half. Jackson with a miss, but an offensive rebound to Robinson, and that's what the 6'5 senior does best, control the boards. Nice head fake by Zolman. Too strong on her 3. And here's a reach-in steal. Hodges, 2-on-1, August. Augustus gets the basket, and it's 25-19, LSU on the run.
I tell you, the Lady Vols did a tremendous job on the offensive boards. The shot's not falling, and, you know, Andy Landers mentioned that LSU is one of the best teams in the SEC. When they come up with those steals like Hodges did on that, they're off to the races.
The LSU fans are on their feet. Under 40 seconds to go in the half, 10 on the shot clock.
And the Tennessee fans are a little shell-shocked.
Jackson throws it right to Hodges. LSU can play for one shot. Smart play by Danica Hodges to pull it out. And now Augustus will take it herself. Not a good decision. At least 15 seconds on the clock for Tennessee. And Pokey Chapman is really upset with that shot. Just pounding her fist on the sideline. And now Butts against Hodges. Strip. Another steal for LSU. What a job defensively they did in the first half. Andy, they're not intimidated by Tennessee at all.
Well, they play them too much, and they've beaten them in the SEC tournament last year and then the year before that. So they felt very confident coming into this game.
It's the lowest scoring first half of the season for Tennessee. The Lady Volunteers held to 19. Let's go to Doris Burke. Doris.
Coach, a sensational half on the defensive side of the ball. What made you so good over there?
No, I think it just comes with this time of year. We didn't have a great showing out in Knoxville. We had some momentum coming into this game, and we knew what we needed to do to be effective against Tennessee, and the kids did it from the first possession.
Shimon Augustus, just 2 of 9. What can you do to make her more effective in the second half?
I think she's still effective because she's drawing so much attention. Other people are able to score. We're playing off of Shimon. Doesn't mean she's going to get the points, but someone else will.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck in the second half. Mike?
All right. Thanks, Doris. LSU with a 6-point halftime lead here in New Orleans, 25-19 over Tennessee. That's it from the floor. Let's go to Reese.
All right, Mike, glad to have you with us on the singular halftime report. And the key for the second half is going to be the health of Tamika Johnson of LSU. We saw her limping off the floor. Nell Fortner, Stacey Dale Schumann joining me now. And Nell, you have a Home Depot coaching adjustment for us, something we look for in the second half.
Well, I tell you, right now, Tennessee switching defenses is hurting them. It's giving them mismatches on the floor. It's putting Taisha Fluker on a big kid. But right here, you see LSU running their motion offense. They do a lot of screening, but right on this ball reversal, Sydney Spencer is going to get back screened by Tilly Willis, and they're going to switch on this. So Ashley Robinson's going to take the other post, and now Sydney Spencer is beat to the basket because of the switch. She doesn't have enough time to turn around and guard that layup right there. Tennessee can quit the switching and just help and recover to shooters.
The other big difference in this basketball game is the battle of the boards. We're at 21-21 right now. Remember early in the year when these two teams played? Well, LSU got out-rebounded by 16. That didn't happen this time around.
You guys said before the game that it certainly was going to be a key, and LSU came out very aggressively, blown way up there. But LSU was all over the board, Stacey.
They're doing a great job blocking out. They're relentless on the pursuit of the offensive boards, and I love the bench play. That's Trinell Clavel right there. She's doing an excellent job off the bench, as we've seen all tournament long. The bigs are moving for LSU right now.
Well, I tell you, I think you're right about the rebound, Stacy. And right now, because of the early strong board by LSU, that's why they had the lead. Tennessee, valiant effort coming back, but the early rebounding hurt them.
Now, the other good thing that LSU is doing is they're pushing the Tennessee post away from the basket, and that's important because they can't get in a rhythm around the hoop.
LSU with a 25-19 lead at the half. This is just the first of two national semifinals. We continue on the singular halftime report. Minnesota head coach Pam Borton will join us as her Gophers get set to take on UConn. Stay with us, everybody.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship is brought to you by Audi. Log on to ESPN.com for more college hoops coverage.
Nice Harley.
Thanks.
Yeah, I was going to get one of those myself, but I spent the $64.95 on a killer dinette set. It was tough, you know? It was Harley, dinette set, Harley, dinette set.
The all-new Sportster is here.
Went with a dinette set.
The bike you've always wanted starts at $64.95.
Hello? Yes, we're looking to buy a home.
Who is it?
Wow, that sounds like a really good loan. What's the interest rate on that? And the origination fee? That's about 3 times what people are normally charged. Hello? Hello? Must have been something I said.
When you're knowledgeable, no one can take advantage of you. Get the facts before you borrow. Call the Fannie Mae Foundation for a free guide and a list of lenders and credit counselors.
Hoop fans, don't miss your chance to go to the 2005 Women's Final Four at the RCA Dome in Indianapolis, April 3rd and 5th. Log on to NCAAsports.com to apply for tickets online. That's NCAAsports.com.
And don't forget the 2005 Men's Final Four, April the 2nd and 4th at the Edward Jones Dome in St. Louis. Log on to NCAAsports.com to apply for tickets online. That's NCAAsports.com, the official website of the NCAA.
What can be better than watching all the incredible goals, great stars, and excitement of an MLS match? Watching well over 100 MLS matches this season. The only way to do that is by signing up now for MLS Direct Kick. For only $69, you can catch all the live action and drama the entire MLS season has to offer. Show your passion for the sport you love. Call 1-800-333-DISH to sign up for the MLS Direct Kick package for a full season of great soccer.
It's time. It's time for movies that fascinate and events that exhilarate. It's time to see the hottest concert of the year, Britney Spears, in concert this month, only on Showtime. Order Showtime Unlimited now and get a $25 gift card from the store for Britney and more. FYE, for your entertainment, it's time to get Showtime. Order Showtime Unlimited now.
Halftime Report is presented by Singular, the wireless company that fits you best.
But when the Saints go marching in, and Tennessee is the only program that has marched into a three-peat of national championships, UConn hopes to follow suit on Tuesday night. Tennessee and LSU in the first of our national semifinal. LSU up by six. UConn hoping to repeat a little history.
Summit.
Back-to-back championships. They have won their third straight national championship. 39-0, Connecticut is perfect. Huskies with back-to-back national championships.
Well, someone who would like to answer that question with a resounding no joins us right now. Minnesota head coach Pam Borton. Her team's going to take on UConn in the second national semifinal. Pam, your team's been really fun to watch as they've made their way through this tournament. And we know that getting Lindsey Whalen back from her hand injury certainly helped you just by putting her back on the floor. But how did losing her affect the team that we see now?
Well, we got much better as a team. Everybody else had to step up and assume new roles. During that point, everybody got a lot more confidence in themselves and each other. Janelle McCarville had to learn how to play without Lindsey Whalen, and it's made us a more dangerous team now with the addition of Lindsey.
Pam, you were at Boston College for 5 years as an assistant. We know you broke down all those UConn tapes every time you played them. How did that help you prepare your team, the familiarity you have with UConn? How did that help in this preparation?
Well, it helped tremendously. I know their personnel extremely well, their system, just their whole mindset. I've been watching them for I don't know how many years, and you just know their mindset. They got the hearts of a champion, and they're a little different this year than they've been in the past, so I think we're going to be ready.
Coach, when you took the job a couple years ago, how were you initially received by your players, the Minnesota players?
I think just with a big, just a lot of apprehension. You know, third coach in 3 years, you know, we don't know how much to trust you. That whole deal, they didn't want to jump in with 2 feet, and it needed a little nurturing and just a little work, and everything worked out for the best.
You know, I ran into some guys last night that drove 23 hours in a pickup truck all the way from Minnesota to come down and see your team. Have you been at all surprised by the reception you've gotten from the fans?
Not at all. I mean, we have over 14,000 people at our games at Williams Arena. It's probably one of the best environments to play in college basketball. And they've just embraced our team. They feel like they're part of the program, and it's been a lot of fun this year.
A lot of them do feel that way. A lot of them have made their way down the Mississippi River to be here for the game tonight. Pam, thanks a lot. Best of luck to you.
Thanks a lot.
All right, Pam Borton, the head coach at Minnesota. Her team takes on UConn in just a little while. And speaking of UConn, the Husky men play for the national championship against Georgia Tech Monday night. Yellow Jackets' Paul Hewitt destroyed the Huskies in the preseason NIT. We'll see how the championship game turns out on Monday night. Right now, our first national semifinal in the women's Final Four. Tamika Johnson hobbled but not stopped. LSU is up by 6.
My old Nationwide wireless plan said they didn't charge me for roaming. Yeah, right. If I stayed in network, but if you can't even see the network, yoo-hoo! Network, I'm in the network. Oh, network, how do you stay in it?
There's no in or out of network with the new Singular Nation. You never pay roaming or long distance. Plus, you get free unlimited calling to all Singular customers nationwide.
I call it my plan.
The new Singular Nation, another reason Singular fits you best.
If you want to tame your turf, you can. If you want to subdue your sod, you can. Right now at the Home Depot, get no payments and no interest for 12 months on all mower and tractor purchases store-wide, including an exclusive lineup of great brands like Honda, Toro, and even John Deere. Just use your Home Depot consumer credit card. If you want to create the lawn of your life and cut your costs too, you can. The Home Depot. You can do it, we can help.
Now there's a non-drowsy medicine that lets you breathe again. Allivert Allergy and Sinus relieves sinus pressure, runny nose, and nasal congestion. Breathe again with Allivert Allergy and Sinus. The right relief, wherever you are.
If you want the benefits of refinancing, you have no choice but to stress over a long application, right? Wrong. AmeriQuest Mortgage gives you a choice and a personal loan specialist to handle just about everything. With two decades of experience, AmeriQuest knows how to offer you the no-stress home loan. The time is right, so call AmeriQuest now at 1-800-287-1533. Or go to AmeriQuest.com. Call AmeriQuest, the company that knows you are more.
Quick, in the top five water polo players in the world. Okay, how about one? Yeah. I didn't start playing water polo to get famous. And the same goes for being a biology major. I like working in protein chemistry. Quick, in the top five protein chemists in the world.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
This halftime report is presented by Singular, the wireless company that fits you best.
We're at the break, our first national semifinal. Later on tonight, UConn will take on Minnesota in the Women's Final Four. And last night, at an establishment in New Orleans, the UConn women got together to watch the Husky men defeat Duke by the narrowest of margins. And now, Gino Auriemma's team hoping to take another step toward a three-peat. Diana Taurasi in her senior season has UConn back in the Final Four. An unprecedented fifth straight Final Four appearance for the Huskies. They'll take on Minnesota in just a little while. Between games in the national semifinals, we will break down that game, let you get to know the Golden Gophers a little bit better. But we've got a second half here in New Orleans right now. LSU on top of Tennessee, 25-19. Simone Augustus just 3 of 10 from the floor. What does LSU need to do to get her started offensively?
Well, I tell you what, they've got to just keep the ball in her hands. What I like about Simone right now is she's not afraid to shoot the ball. She's still willing to put up shots, and shooters have to be able to do that, have that confidence, and she has not lost her confidence.
For Tennessee, they really like to work out of the 1-4 high set. They pass the ball to the high post and move off of it with a handoff. I think, and I would just say from watching the first half, that they can get that handoff player shots if they pay attention to that. The players are converging defensively to the ball, and I think that they can step back and hit a shot.
Well, the other thing is Tennessee has to hit the easy shot in the paint. They've missed layups, and they've got to shoot the ball better than that.
And Tamika Johnson hobbled in the first half. How healthy will she be in the second? LSU has a 6-point lead at the moment. Simone Augustus shooting 66% in this tournament, only 30% in the first half. 3 of 10 from the floor for the LSU star. Can she get going? The Bayou Bengals still up by 6. Second half just around the corner.
This is a map of my Nationwide wireless plan. But if I go mobile to mobile, there's this whole different map that's Nationwide, but not this Nationwide. And these other maps, they're all Nationwide. And all different.
With the new Singular Nation, you never have to worry about maps on any call because you never pay roaming or long distance. Get free unlimited calling to all Singular customers nationwide.
I call it my Nationwide Means Nationwide plan.
The new Singular Nation, another reason Singular fits you best.
Hey, Tito. I hope you enjoy the empanadas and Coke. Love, Mom. Aw.
Hey, man. Something smells good.
Hi, Tito.
Hey, man.
You've got to step up. Close out all of the pressure. Trust everything you've been taught. And just believe you can do it. You know, my first day on the job sure felt familiar.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
The heavyweight division is up for grabs with two titles on the line in one night. Bird risks it all against Galata, and Ruiz stakes his belt against Oquendo in a Latino showdown. Bird versus Galata, Ruiz versus Oquendo, plus a welterweight championship extra, Mayorga versus Rivera. All Saturday, April 17th, live on pay-per-view. It's a heavyweight night. Let the next era begin.
America's favorite home gym is more affordable than ever. Now you can get the all-new Bowflex Extreme for just $19 a month. That's less than most health club dues. Great results are easy. Just one simple workout, 20 minutes a day, three times a week to get in awesome shape. Powerful arms, defined legs, and a toned, sexy core are just a phone call away. Call us for a free DVD or video, or visit us online to get a real Bowflex for just $19 a month today.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship is brought to you by Coca-Cola. Let's make it real.
We're in New Orleans. We're at 25-19, LSU over Tennessee at the half. Let's check in with Mark Jones. Mark.
Guys, inside the Tennessee locker room, Pat Summitt, the head coach, talking first and foremost defensively, saying we have got to deny the middle of the floor to the Tigers, and more importantly, stop Tamika Johnson's dribble penetration. It's killing us. Offensively, more ball reversal, no more three. She was demanding about that, and she looked at her All-American, Shira Eli, and said, do those people know what they're talking about? You better prove that they do. Back to you guys.
It's always good to have a challenge, and Shira Eli is going to have to be the one to step up. Hodges with a drive. Beautiful left-hand basket, and the lead is 8, the biggest of the game for LSU.
I think Danica Hodges is the unsung hero in this team. Averages 14 points, but is willing to sacrifice her game for defense.
And does it very quietly for those 14. Zolman tries a no-look pass. Fortunately, has it dropped right back to her. Eli tries to shot and partially blocked. Willis, nice defense. Now Augustus the other way. Little pull-up out of control. Missed it. Fights for the rebound. And here comes Tennessee.
Again, you look at the foul trouble that Tennessee had in that first half, Mike, and Shira Eli only played 7 minutes.
Great fake by Butts as she got the offensive rebound and then drew Willis into the air to get the foul.
There's a shot by Eli, and just a nice little ball fake by LaToya Davis. That's great. I mean, just didn't go down, just used the arms, long arms up there, and get herself to the free throw line. And that was a big difference in the first half.
Sorry, I said Butts. It was obviously LaToya Davis, and she hits the free throw, 78% from the stripe on the year.
And Pat Summitt's got to be a little concerned, too. She had two starters that did not score at all in that first half. Shira Eli, we said she was on the bench, and Ashley Robinson.
Johnson, who led the SEC and is third nationally in assists, runs this club with Hodges in the backcourt. They try to hit Augustus. Hodges is too strong to the All-American. Let's go to Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, that last play exactly opposite of what Pokey Chapman was hoping for coming out of the locker room. She said the only thing she'd like to see done differently is that they attack more intelligently on the offensive end. Their system is set up not to fight Tennessee's pressure. If they take away the cut high, they're supposed to go low. That turnover cannot please her out of the initial look, guys.
That was their sixth, Doris. They got off to a poor start but have settled down since then. Shot clock at 5. Eli. Good defense by LSU, and now Butts out of the corner can't hit it. Nice outlet pass to Hodges, 2-on-3. And a blocking foul call on Zolman, and she nearly explodes off the floor after the call. That looked like another charge to me.
Well, Pat, someone almost exploded out of that sideline to come onto the court, and good heads-up play by Johnson to get it going, and it's what we saw in the first half. There was the same play that they called.
Looked like either a charge or a no call. Hodges can't hit inside. Well, Tennessee did its job defensively in the first half. They held Simone Augustus to 3 out of 10 scoring. 3 out of 10 shooting, rather. She still came through with 8 first-half points after a couple of free throws. And Shira Eli just can't buy one for Tennessee.
But as much as Simone Augustus did not score, Mike, I really think she had a pretty solid game. Yeah, the shot's not falling for her, but she's got 6 rebounds in that first half, and she's been a decoy. Tennessee has focused on her so much that everybody else is stepping up.
Solomon off the inbounds, can't get it to drop, and here come the Lady Tigers. Augustus in the middle of the break. Willis forced it up, and they call an offensive foul on Willis.
Okay. I don't know what to say on that one because it was the same play coming down, and I don't think that the defense had themselves set. Not a great pass by Simone Augustus on Willis because the spacing wasn't great, but that was a tough call.
Second on Willis. Tennessee has hit absolutely nothing from the outside, and they've got some good outside shooters. Robinson at 6'5". Puts the ball on the floor, lost it. Got it back. 2 on the shot clock. They throw it away again. Johnson, nice dish. Augustus with the basket. Tamika Johnson, their all-time assist leader, has her 3rd dish of the night.
What a pass by Tamika Johnson. Talk about a speed demon. She ran track, and she came up with a great steal.
And that's with a bad leg, courtesy of a lot of contact in the first half. Great double team. LSU playing terrific defense against Tennessee. Butts looked like she was out of rhythm on that one. Got the offensive rebound on the tip and scored.
Good hustle by Tasha Butts to not quit on the play. Tennessee really struggling inside, Mike. And Tasha Butts took that outside shot, maybe forced it a little bit, but she follows her shot. And that's one of the things they really worked on in practice today, Pat Summitt. Not telling the senior, but telling her younger players that they can learn from the senior like Tasha Butts to follow their shots.
Butts has been the team leader on this club down the stretch. She has great communication with Pat Summitt. Those point guards have to have with their coach. 29-24, LSU. Johnson, beautiful crossover. Had it blocked by Eli. And then stolen by Augustus, but she stepped out of bounds.
Tried to get the timeout.
Great hustle by Simone Augustus, and she comes up limping a little bit.
Well, Johnson just sets you up, doesn't she? I mean,
doesn't she
such
ever.
A decoy, and then bam, she just explodes.
And she's still hurting, still limping when she lands on that left leg and grimacing up and down the court. Tennessee just having a wicked time shooting the basketball. Under 30%. Solomon out of the corner. She can't hit.
They need for her to get hot.
Boy, they do. And she is a 42% long-range shooter. One of the best they've ever had at Tennessee. She can't buy one today. Augustus guarded by Solomon right now. And a pushing foul on Robinson. Her 2nd of the night. LSU continues to lead. They've had the advantage from the start.
ESPN The Magazine on newsstands now.
You know, when I was a young man riding a Harley-Davidson motorcycle, oh, that's all I could think of. I mean that open road, that rumbling engine, the wind in my face.
Don't be in a hurry.
Now I never got it. I spent the money on aluminum siding instead.
Let's go see what Grandma's doing.
The all-new Sportster is here. The bike you've always wanted starts at $64.95.
Where would we be if we always did things the way they were done before? Where would we be if everyone followed and no one led?
I'm never ever gonna get it up. I'm never ever gonna get it
up. America's favorite home gym is more affordable than ever. Now you can get the all-new Bowflex Extreme for just $19 a month. That's less than most health club dues. Great results are easy. Just one simple workout, 20 minutes a day, three times a week to get in awesome shape. Powerful arms, defined legs, and a toned, sexy core are just a phone call away. Call us for a free DVD or video, or visit us online to get a real Bowflex for just $19 a month today.
Consumers keep choosing Yellow Book Yellow Pages.
We'll find out which directory really has the right stuff.
And argue with science.
Start the engine.
Take it up to 20 miles per hour.
20 miles per hour.
Pick it up to 580.
Sir, crank it up to 580!
I didn't realize Yellow Book has so much in it.
Imagine the phone company beaten in our own tunnel.
Once again, it's Yellow Book, not the other book. Call 1-800-YB-YELLOW.
LSU by five, and Ann Myers, if they win this ball game, it is going to be because of a tenacious defense.
They came out right from the gates as far as defense is concerned, and you saw Hostin with the nice block, and then you see Tilly Willis with a hand on the ball, and Danica Hodges stripping it there, and then Tamika Johnson stepping into the passing lanes. They have been all over. Six steals for this LSU team, and they're converting off them.
Tennessee had shot so well in the tournament, 46% through the first four games. Tonight, one out of four, 25%. They have to struggle woefully, and a lot of that credit has to go to the LSU defense.
When Nell Fortner and Mike talk about halftime, Tennessee adjusting with the switches. Well, defensively, kind of set up in a zone there. It looked like a matchup, but, you know, Pat Summitt was adamant about switching on those picks.
Hodges goes baseline and picks up a foul on the drive. It'll be on Spencer. The freshman gets her second. Augustus with 10 points. She was held to 12 the first time these two teams played. That was a season's low. What a shot by Wendell Jones on the follow.
I'd say there's been some wild plays in this game, haven't there?
There have. And Eli hasn't made any of them. Now she hits the jumper. Shira Eli with her first basket almost 25 minutes into the game.
And that was a pretty shot, too.
They'll need a few more. Hodges guarded by Spencer. Works around the screen. Got a mismatch inside and get the ball to Jones. She bobbled. Johnson rims out a jumper from the baseline. Here come the Lady Balls. Kick it ahead to Davis. Look at that burst. Then she missed a shot and gets it back on the contact with Wendell Jones jump ball. Possession arrow will give it to Tennessee.
Now you can really see the Lady Vols, Mike, I think, trying to pick up the tempo. They want to push it a little bit more. LSU has been doing it in this game. They've controlled the tempo of the game, but they're kind of slowing it down when they want to. But Tennessee needs to push it to feel like they can get things going.
Well, they could use a couple of easy baskets in this game to help them get back. Davis, a little lob pass. Nice steal by Chance. She is so quick. Augusta, season opening, takes it on the baseline and missed. The rebound to Ashley Robinson. Again, Davis trying to push it up court. Butts for three, in and out. Robinson with the follow and foul from behind.
And Tennessee continues to hit the drought from the three-point range. LSU has only taken one. That was early in the first half by Simone Augustus, but Tennessee, long-range jumpers are not going.
Big foul on Tilly Willis. That was her third.
But really not a bad foul if you're fouling Ashley Robinson.
No, because Robinson at the line 0 for 3 today. And the Tennessee seniors, believe it or not, have not won an SEC championship or an NCAA championship. That's unheard of. That's totally unheard of for this club. And in fact, none of the Final Four teams won their conference tournament.
No. And it's such a talented team, but it also shows you, too, that, you know, Pat Summitt continues to have one of the toughest schedules in the country and play in front of huge crowds and go on the road. And they have to play at their best because teams are ready for them and they want to beat them.
Ashley Robinson now 0 for 4 from the free throw line. Tamika Johnson, who says, I know I'm small, I've got to be special. Basket won't fall for Jones, but she gets the foul. Wendell Jones with good individual moves on the baseline. And that was on Robinson, her third.
Well, I tell you, the post players for LSU, they've really done an excellent job so far in this game as far as going to Ashley Robinson. She's an incredible shot blocker, but she has struggled from the floor.
Wendell Jones is a sophomore from Grosnell, Arkansas, making her 18th consecutive start. You see the free throw story. Tennessee only 6 of 12. LSU with not much of an advantage. They've only hit 10 of 17 now as a team. And the lead is at 6, under 14 minutes to go. And Eli will take the ball out of bounds as Robinson goes to the bench at the 13:57 mark.
Yeah, after that Georgia game, again, that Tennessee had lost in the SEC tournament, they only got 2 points from Fluker and Robinson. And the centers for Tennessee said, we've got to get a double-double together. Well, they don't. They've got 2 points and 4 rebounds. That's it.
One of the reasons they're down by 6. And the outside shooting for Tennessee has been non-existent. But tried to get the entry pass to Fluker. She couldn't hold it. 10 Lady Vol turnovers.
Hey, it's a gutty game right now by Tamika Johnson, how she's leading this team.
Augustus Spencer on her right now in that part of the zone. And wide open out of the corner, Hostin misses the three. LSU has missed some great opportunities to extend this lead. Butts directing traffic. 3-point shooting in this game, 0 for 11 as a team, and we finally have one. Spencer with 7 points, and that quickly cuts the lead to 3.
This LSU team won't take a lot of 3-point shots. They only average 8.9 a game.
Augustus unable to hit. Here comes Butts. Zolman had it knocked out of bounds and a good reach in defense again by Tamika Johnson.
Thanks
the one thing about Tennessee, and they have won so many games at the end throughout the course of Pat Summitt's career. If it comes down to a 1-point game, at the end of this one, they expect to win.
Well, that's what we talked about in the beginning of this game, the kind of games that they've won this year and they've been behind.
Great pass and a better catch by Augustus.
But I tell you, this is a LSU team that I don't think is going to be denied. I know there's a lot of time left in this game. This is a very close game, but LSU wants to win this for Sue Gunner. Pokey Chapman, who's done a great job for her mentor.
Sue Gunner will come back next year. Pokey Chapman says she's happy to come back as the associate head coach. And that could have been an offensive foul on Butts, as she lowered a shoulder and pushed off. Shot clock down to 1. They have to force it up. Shira Eli gets the rebound. And it looked like Eli was fouled going for the rebound. It is really getting tough out there. 5-point lead. The star has been Tamika Johnson. That one to our All-American Simone Augustus.
Thank you. Introducing Bacardi Silver Limon Premium Malt Beverage. 5% alcohol by volume. Flavor your night.
No more biking for you.
It's the moment of choice. Tylenol or Advil. Advil can give you stronger relief. It contains the medicine doctors recommend most for tough muscle pain, strains, and sprains. Advance to Advil Relief.
Every week, Sports Illustrated brings you the real story, inside and raw. The story you won't find anywhere else. Now, SI brings you something even more. Call now, and for the first time ever, you'll score this multifunction DVD player with remote control, free with your paid subscription. Your state-of-the-art player features progressive scanning and 32 times fast-forward motion and rewind. It's absolutely loaded. But best of all, it's free when you order 56 issues of SI for just $1.59 an issue. Save over 50% off the cover price. Order with your credit card, and you also get your choice of movies on DVD. Remember the Titans or Bull Durham free. Don't miss your chance to get a DVD player and movie when you get the real story in Sports Illustrated. Call now.
LSU continues to hold a five-point lead, 11:42 to go in the ballgame. The excitement of the women's Final Four in high definition continues with UConn against Minnesota next. Phillips and Best Buy bring you ESPN HD on your old TV set at home. That's what you see. Now, if you have high definition, look at the lower right. You get the extra perspective. So just to show you how fortunate I am at home, I have drawn those red lines on my HD set, just so I know how much more I'm getting.
I need to get one of those HD
sets. Oh, they're great. But we're always gone when stuff's on that we're watching.
We're on.
That's right. But nice screen to get to the baseline by Fluker, and then Tasha Fluker with the follow. She did a great job twice on that possession.
Tennessee setting up in his own defense and forcing LSU to shoot from the outside. LSU, they've played against a lot of teams, Mike, this year that play them zone because they're not an outside shooting team, but they won a lot of those games too.
Well, a lot of that is because Tamika Johnson has been able to break those zones, and Augustus gets the good shot. Shot clock at 6. Dangerous cross-court pass. They get it to Augustus with a hand in her face. Jones, offensive rebound, and that's a jump ball. Possession arrow to LSU.
What LSU does against that zone, they get Simone Augustus in the lane. I thought she got hit on the arm.
But I'm sure you wouldn't get any argument from the LSU bench. Spencer with a reach and a steal. She and Hodges went down together, and the foul will be called on Spencer. That's 3 on Spencer. 4 on Spencer. And the freshman, 10:57 to go in the game, the 4 personal foul. Johnson, great drive. Banks it up, can't get it. Spencer with a rebound.
And this is where Tennessee's got to look to get some rebounds out of that zone. And, you know, the thing is for LSU, they feel comfortable in their zone offense.
Foul away from the ball. This will be on Wendlin Jones, her 3rd. And a fresh 30 on the shot clock for Tennessee.
Spencer,
nice pass. Boy, they would have had an easy layup. Zolman finally hits a 3, and she ties it.
You can't keep that kid down too long. She practices where she wants to make 200 to 300 shots, not take them, make them.
She is the former number one scorer in Indiana high school history, averaged 37 points a game in high school, shooting them just like that.
Here comes the feel what it's like to have the hot hand in the hottest selling car in its class. Pontiac Vibe. Official performance machine of the NCAA Women's Final Four.
There are two sides to me. The all-conference catcher side, that's my tough side. And the side of me studying for a career in marine mammal rescue, that's my soft side. I'm finding I really need both sides to be the whole person that I want to be.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sport.
Having trouble sleeping? Well, you're not alone. Nearly 70 million of us Americans can't get enough sleep. And no wonder with all the stress today. Now there's a natural way to get the rest you need. It's called the Nautilus Sleep System. Nautilus's unique air chamber design allows you to personalize your comfort every night just by inflating or deflating the pressure. And your spouse is gonna love this bed too, because the dual zones allow them to control their own comfort. You gotta call this toll-free number now to get a free video that tells you all about it. Now you can get one of these great mattresses for as little as $25 a month. And Nautilus lets you actually sleep on the bed for 90 nights to make sure you really love it. Hey, a better mattress means better rest, naturally. Call now for your free video or visit them online at greatsleep.com and start getting the natural sleep you need.
Knotted at 34, Tennessee starting them out a bit of a comeback. I'm with a little bit of Tennessee royalty right now. Carol Lawson and Tamika Catchings. Let me in on what you had, your conversation about leadership with Tasha Buss.
Well, Tasha called me prior to this season and just wanted to talk about stepping up and being a leader for this team. And I told her, I said, Tasha, if you're going to do that, you have to have the courage as a leader to tell your teammates sometimes things that they don't want to hear but that they need to hear.
Tell me about this team here. They say that there's not a lot of stars like back when you guys played in the day. What are your thoughts on that? Do they have stars, real stars?
They have stars. You know, one of the things that they've really been concentrating on all this year is everybody stepping up and playing. And I think with the loss of Lauren Moore, Tasha Buss has really stepped up, and she's been the great leader for this team.
All right, guys, they could certainly use you two right now. Back to you, Mike.
And LSU could really use Simone Augustus, since she came through on the last possession with a line drive jumper. Augustus with 14, the lead back to LSU by a bucket. And a double dribble. Tennessee turns it over. Let's go to Doris Burke. Doris.
Well, as Tennessee has sat in this zone for the stages of this second half, Pokey Chapman told her team, listen, make sure we use pass fakes, penetrate the gaps, get some cuts from the weak side. You saw Simone Augustus on their last possession attack a gap. Hodges does the same thing there, Mike.
And a great ball fake by Hodges to get wide open, but she can't hit the shot.
Well, LSU does a very good job taking care of the basketball. They average under 13 turnovers a game, but right now Tennessee has taken over the rebounding lead, and they're only two behind, but those rebounds, they've gotten them back into this game plus that zone.
Boy, and LSU was killing them on the boards early. Zolman guarded very tightly by Johnson, shot clock down to five. Butts tries to go inside to Shira Eli, can't do it, who's been held to 2 points. The Kodak All-American, one first half bucket. Now the shot clock is at four, and Tennessee will inbound. Bounce pass along the baseline. We are tied again.
Well, Wendellin Jones just got caught with her back to the ball and didn't see the cutter.
Tennessee has led just once at 6-5. Johnson and Hodges have been able to get inside against this zone. Jones goes baseline and draws another foul.
Well, LSU, Mike, does such a good job in this zone offense. They're very patient. They don't get rattled by it. And coming out of the practice, LSU practice, we've got to make Tennessee play defense for as long as they can.
Pokey Chapman, who will be looked at in the offseason by a lot of people, I think, as a potential head coaching candidate. She said she is open to that.
And certainly what she has done as the interim head coach has been nothing short of brilliant. And Jones gets the nice bounce on that one. Coming up when we're done, of course, a matchup of All-American guards, Minnesota and UConn. There's Lindsey Whalen. School-leading scorer, fifth in the history of the Big Ten. Just a tremendous player. Jones hits both free throws, and LSU back by two. And Tilly Willis will come back in for Pokey Chapman, and Jones will go to the bench. Where are the points going to come from Tennessee?
In Tennessee, you got to continue to look at Natasha Butts and Shira Ealer, but I think Sidney Spencer's a player that can score points. So can Zolman. They've got players out there that can score points. Robinson's not going to get them, but she'll be in the defensive end with the blocks.
Butts is the leader so far. She has eight. Shira Eli in a double team. Spencer at the baseline. Now Eli. Shot clock at seven. Robinson, good head fake, but way off on the shot. And the loose ball rebound goes to Willis.
And what LSU has done, Mike, they've just sagged off. They're forcing Tennessee to take those shots. They want to go inside, but LSU has backed off defensively.
They'll let Robinson shoot 10, 12 footers all day.
Well, you saw that. She at least hit glass.
Augustus flashes across the lane, shoots the runner, and misses. Spencer with the rebound. .729 and counting. The first semifinal from the Final Four. And Eli misses again. Shira Eli averages 15 points a game. On the season, she has been held to two in this one.
And normally she makes those kind of shots. What a tough shot.
Johnson just fired it up there. The follow shot won't go. Corvell had a crack at it. And Tennessee comes out with the ball.
Well, against Colgate, the first tournament game for this Tennessee team, Shira Eli, 4 points and no rebounds.
Eli, fadeaway jumper, that one won't go. Spencer kept it alive. Butts puts it up, and Butts comes out with it again. Zolman with a chance to reset at the 640 mark. Boy, and look at Johnson. She just goes out, and whoever she gets, in this case Zolman, and challenges them.
They say she's a replica of Pokey Chapman. When Chapman played, he was a three-time All-American.
Pretty good role model. Now Spencer, shot clock at four. Eli, baseline, and she's fouled by Willis.
That's one thing LSU has worked on with Shira Eli. Let her go right. She doesn't like to score right. She's really underneath the basket there, Mike, and they really look for that spin move when she goes back to her left.
Leading scorer and rebounder for this ball club. All year long. Junior out of Indianapolis. Hits the first and tie it with the next one. Jalanda Hostin is back in for LSU. And so is Wendland Jones after a brief rest. 3 points for Eli. Augustus will get a little breather. Free throw is good by Eli. We are tied at 38, only 6:20 to go. These longtime rivals going at each other for the right to play for a national title 48 hours from now.
I guess some cars are just natural born followers. Got no motivation, no drive. But this car has a different vibe. It's all about forward progress, maximum momentum, 16-valve power, six on the floor. Just give it a destination and go where the vibe takes you. The 2004 Vibe GT. The new Power Pontiac. That's fuel for the soul.
Get the hottest selling car in its class. Visit your Pontiac dealer.
Hey, yo, Thirst, let me get a Sprite.
No doubt. What's better than Sprite when it's hotter than a devil's drawers?
Oh, here he goes.
I'm serious. That thirst quenching lemon lime hitting the back of your throat. Splatter. Really? Name one thing that's better. You can't. There is nothing better. I dare you. I double dog dare you. I defy you to name one thing. All right. Name two. Show him my motto. Hey, girls. Throw it in reverse for Thirst.
I'm here with Tim and Sarah. Today's project, heavy-duty outdoor cleaning.
The Craftsman cleaning system is unbelievable. Perfect for tough outdoor cleanup jobs.
Yeah, Briggs & Stratton, 2,500 pounds of pressure per square inch.
And how about this two-tank deal? Great, isn't it?
Makes switching cleaners quick and easy.
And with four quick-change spray tips, you can handle all kinds of dirt on all kinds of surfaces. Get the Craftsman cleaning system for just $379.99, only from Sears.
Bob, I gotta tell you, this hose and nozzle are practically indestructible.
And did you notice how easily the nozzle adjusts to all the different spray settings?
I love that.
Get the 50-foot Craftsman rubber hose for just $19.99, and the Craftsman hose nozzle for only $14.99.
Now this looks good.
Yep, got my own system, thanks to Craftsman.
An innovative tool for every project. Ideas for the good life. Craftsman at Sears. Good life, great price.
Tied at 38, 6:20 to go in the ballgame between LSU and Tennessee. Our Harley-Davidson game track, LSU, 23-0 when they are leading it to half. They led it to half in this one. Field goals for Tennessee, only 28%, but they're still tied. Even though Shira Eli, their leading scorer, has 4 points.
This is a slugout. I mean, really, because Tennessee's shooting a 28%, LSU 31%, and only one player on the court, Simone Augustus, who's not on the court, actually, but she's the only player between these two teams that is in double figures with 14 points. Nobody else on the floor has double figures.
The worst shooting percentage for Tennessee all year was 34%. Right now, they're well below that. Shot clock at 7. Hostin, nice job to get in the lane and gets the roll on the shot. And a timeout for LSU as they regain the lead at 40-38.
It was about the 16-minute mark when Tennessee went into that 2-3 zone, and they were down 5. And then they tied it, and they kept it close.
When you were playing, did you find that going into a zone defense took away from your aggression as an offensive player?
I think as a man-to-man team, you dictate the defense. And when you play a zone, you're really reacting, and you're not controlling it as much. And Tennessee is not a team that plays a lot of zone. They have played zone this year.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so you don't want to go into something that didn't get you here in the first place.
The winner of our first semifinal will meet the winner of Cinderella, number 7 Minnesota, against second-seeded UConn. And let's check in with Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Mike Pokey Chapman told her team that Tennessee is not scoring out of their offense. They're scoring out of second and third chances. She said, box out, show some heart. On the offensive end, she said, I want you to execute every time down like it's the last possession of the game. Don't settle for anything. Be confident.
Davis will draw the foul. Thank you, Doris. And no, you don't want to settle. You want the best shot possible. That foul was on Hostin, her third. And Davis will go to the free throw line for the 1-1, 78% shooter.
And you said that that was a key in the beginning of this game, Mike, as far as the second and third opportunities for Tennessee. And they are leading in the rebounding. They're not shooting the ball right.
Davis 3-for-3 from the line tonight. Now, neither team's going to get style points for this, but they don't care. They just want to win. Davis, 8 points, tied again at 40. Here comes Johnson, nice dish to Augustus. Tamika Johnson makes things happen, and Augustus finishes them off. And Tamika Johnson with 5 assists, that ties an all-time NCAA record for a single tournament.
But what a heads-up play to push it after a made basket to kick it out that quick, and Tennessee was lackadaisical getting back.
And she is so quick. Tennessee picking up its intensity offensively a little more. Butts, great spin, couldn't hit it, then got the basket and drew the foul. Great second effort by Tasha Butts.
Butts made that great spin move, Mike. I don't think she knew where she was. She was too far underneath, couldn't get the angle. The ball almost goes straight up. But when she gets a rebound, this is exactly what Pokey Chapman's talking about, getting a defensive rebound. But boy, the Lady Vol alumni are loving it.
Worked out as a pass to herself. Danica Hodges picked up her second. And Butts will go to the line with a chance to give the Lady Vols the lead.
One shot.
10 points, 11 boards. for Tasha Butts. Make it 11-11, a double-double. Tennessee's second lead of the entire game.
And they stay in that zone.
Hodges, boy, she has stepped up tonight. Danica Hodges, the senior from New Orleans, it's a big bucket. She has five.
And you get so keyed in on Simone Augustus where she is on the floor that it leaves other players open.
We call a holding foul on Tamika Johnson. Away from the ball. That's her third. And foul trouble piling up for both ball clubs. That will send Zolman to the line. And this is a given. She's hit 82 out of 86 this year from the free throw line. And you see Tamika Johnson pleading her case. Let's go to Mark. Mark, what do you have?
Yeah, Mike, you mentioned Zolman, 95.3% of the season, a real creature of habit. Her routine, three dribbles, you see it, spin, one more dribble. It's a routine she's been doing since she was in the fourth grade. Her father taught it to her. Not only that, that green wristband she's got on, she's worn that since the fourth grade, too. It's working for her. Back to you.
That's got to be getting a little ratty, hasn't it?
Yeah, she said she had to do some surgery on it with her mom and put some more elasticity with it.
Holding foul called against Tennessee. It'll be on Eli. That's three on Shira Eli. And it will put LSU in the 1-1s. Jones goes to the line. 65% shooter. Trying to get the lead back for the Lady Tigers.
We mentioned that first half. It's going to come down to free throws the way that the game was being played.
And she misses the front end of the 1-1. Butts calls out the offense she wants. Even told Pat Summitt, Shira Eli would have this kind of offensive game and she'd still be ahead. With under 5 minutes to go, she wouldn't have believed it. Shot clock at six. Eli lost her balance on the way in. Zolman inside the three-point line and knocked it down. Got Johnson up in the air, went right by her. The lead is three, the biggest for Tennessee. Good defense by Davis. Johnson just had to toss it up in the air. It's knocked out of bounds off of Robinson out to LSU. 3:41 to go in the game. The Lady Vols have a three-point lead.
Nice Harley.
Thanks.
Yeah, I was gonna get one of those myself, but spent the $64.95 on a killer dinette set. It was tough, you know? It was Harley, dinette set.
The all-new Sportster is here.
Went with a dinette set.
The bike you've always wanted starts at $64.95.
If you wanna get a jump on spring, you can. And if you wanna do it now and pay for it later, you can. Right now at the Home Depot and Expo Design Center, you'll get no payments and no interest for 12 months on everything in the store. Just use your consumer credit card. Or if you don't have one, open a new credit card account and you'll get 10% off your first purchase store-wide. You can save up to $200. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Welcome to the wireless age. Got your HP Pavilion ZT3280 notebook PC featuring Intel Centrino mobile technology. Your HP camera and wireless printer. Setting it up was easy, right, Techno Boy? Because you went to CompUSA for that state-of-the-art HP engineering. Then CompUSA came over, set it up, and trained you for free. Who else gives you so much attention? CompUSA. Unmatched.
Feel what it's like to have the hot hand in the hottest selling car in its class. Pontiac Vibe. Official performance machine of the NCAA Women's Final Four.
The
ESPN's exclusive presentation of the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship is brought to you by Pontiac, official performance machines of the NCAA.
47-44 Tennessee. Let's find out what went on in the huddles during the timeouts. Let's check in with Doris.
Mike Pokey Chapman told her team to continue to play off Simone Augusta. She said Simone will draw lots of attention. Everybody else be active and be aggressive. Hodges gets a look there. For more on Tennessee's huddle, let's go over to Mark Jones.
Yeah, Pat Summitt, Doris said that look out for Johnson Augustus. They're going to try and hurt us with their dribble penetration. Bigs have to help and rotate offensively. They're going to try and run a play here with Butts. A little pick and roll off the high screen. There it is. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Mark. And Tasha Butts for Tennessee with 11 on the shot clock. Eli trying to turn inside, can't hit the shot. LSU basketball. Good defense by Wendland Jones and a nice rebound as well.
And the difference right now, Tennessee having this lead, they are out-rebounding LSU 43-34 and gotten to the free throw line. 10 of 12 to LSU's use, 3 of 5 in the second half.
Augustus had to put it up over the 6'5 Robinson and couldn't hit it. And you can just see a little bit more swagger in Tennessee.
You really can, and we talked about Simone Augustus shooting 66% coming into this game and has really struggled with her shot falling.
Only 7 out of 21. The last time she had a game this bad was against Tennessee in the regular season. She had 5 out of 19. Offensive foul against Tennessee. That is a huge call. They turn it over, and Eli picked up her fourth foul.
Well, they call the push-off. You can see her lean in a little bit to that right side. She's been doing that all game long, Pat Summitt.
I don't think either coach particularly happy at this point. Of course, they never are they?
Tennessee switched back into the man-to-man defense.
Great defense by Eli. Anticipated the pass, got a hand on it.
Caught LSU a little bit off guard. And again, this has been Tennessee's bread and butter. They fell back in that zone, kind of slowed things up now. Now they play pressure defense.
Johnson, who has now set the NCAA single tournament assist record, got the ball inside to Hodges. Hodges with 7. It's a one-point game.
And Tamika Johnson with 7 assists.
She has been terrific the entire tournament. In fact, her entire career, and she's got one more season to go. Oh, Davis, a good ball here. Solomon, Eli, good ball movement by Tennessee, but the shot clock is at 5. There's the lob inside, and Shire Eli appeared to knock it out of bounds. They're going to say it went off Wendland Jones with 3 on the shot clock.
Jones did a good job defensively.
Yes, she did. And now Pat Summitt is going to call a timeout with 3 on the shot clock. This is a critical possession at 1:43 to go in the game. What kind of shot do you want to try to get in 3 seconds?
Well, the biggest thing is they've got to get the ball in bounds. And what they want to do, LSU cannot foul, because putting them at the line, Tennessee, they've been pretty good in this second half. And I think that really hurts them in the sense that you talk about that swagger that Tennessee has right now. LSU's got to play with a lot of confidence.
But if you get the ball inside with only 3 seconds on the shot clock, one of the prime targets is Robinson, and you don't want her going to the line.
Well, no, but you want to go up with that. I don't think they're going to go to Robinson. They've got Butts passing the ball. You always want to have your best passer passing the ball inbounds. But look for Shira Eli, and look for Zolman. Well, now they got Davis taken out, so Butts has a chance to get it.
3 on the shot clock, 1:43 on the game clock. 1-point lead, Solomon around the screen. She can't take this time. Just got it off and made it. Are you kidding? The lead is 4.
As Simone Augustus time, I mean, she's got to take over this game.
Tamika Johnson, what a great drive.
Or it could be Tamika Johnson.
Gee whiz, what a play. 5-3. She goes in among the trees and scores. She had just done it time and time again.
Well, I love the fact that Johnson has no fear, but on the other side, Zolman never panics. She gets Johnson on top of her and stays behind for the 3-point shot. What a clutch, big-time shot to nail it down. And then great penetration by Tamika Johnson, just flinging her body back out there, trying to draw the foul, which she did in the first half and hasn't been in the free throw line in the second half.
The lead is two for the Lady Vols of Tennessee with 1:18 to go. Of course, ESPN HD is going to bring you a lot of exciting events upcoming, starting in about 45 minutes with Tennessee and UConn. Then Tuesday at 9:30, we'll have the NCAA Women's Championship from right here in New Orleans. The winner of this one against the winner of Minnesota and Connecticut. And this one may be far from over.
Well, Tennessee, look for them to come down. They're going to slow it up. They'll use the clock, spread things out, look to get a shot, but they've been so good in this second half, Mike, as far as that second and third opportunity. LSU's just got to, they've got to gut it out right near here in the minute 18 left.
Augustus and Johnson have played their hearts out again. The possession arrow is in favor of Tennessee. Right now, Tennessee has only committed 18 fouls, so a foul non-shooting would be 1-1. Tennessee missed its first 9 three-point shots. They have hit their last three. That's why they're up by two. Butts as they work time off the clock. Shot clock at 9. Robinson did not want the shot. Goes to Zolman. Zolman looks for the screen. And they had to force that. It's a shot clock violation as Shira Eli had to get it off under pressure. Again, LSU with great defense.
Well, you want to take time off the clock. That's well and good. But you also, you've got to start it a little bit sooner. And I thought defensively, LSU did some great switching. And now LSU's got to come down, Mike. They got to convert.
Here comes Johnson. Hodges cutting off the screen. So is Augustus. Johnson just doesn't give up that dribble. She refuses to give up the ball. And gets it inside. The basket is good by Willis. Johnson found a way. 8 assists.
Tennessee looking for that one shot, Blake. Tennessee, the last couple games, they've been in the same situation with Baylor and Stanford.
And Tasha Butts, who has hit the game-winning points in both of those, has it again. Leans in, no. And out of bounds to LSU with 6 seconds left. Well, you knew Tasha Butts was going to have the ball in her hand.
She's been the hero the last couple games.
LSU with a timeout, looking for a chance at a final shot. Tamika Johnson is a special point guard, partner.
Well, look at her keep her dribble. Look at a high dribble, the spin, and look at her stay on the ground. Good possession. She sees the roller going to the basket. She's looking to try and take the shot, but she drew the defense to her.
She has more assists in this NCAA tournament than anybody has ever had. 50 in 5 games. Marvelous tournament.
Impressive names and schools from there, and Pat Summitt calling the timeouts. And in that Stanford game, there were about 3 or 4 timeouts in a row right at the end of the game.
Tennessee takes this one. Now, if you come out in a certain set, the other coach calls timeout. I mean, it's a guessing game, isn't it?
Well, it really is.
Do you change the way you line up, or do you make them think, well, they think we're going to change, so we won't?
Well, with Pat Summitt, you never know in that case. But I look for them to obviously put pressure on LSU, but they can't afford to let the ball go inside. You want them to take a 3-point shot.
The last three games have not been easy for Tennessee against Baylor. Shira Eli fouled with 0.2 seconds left. Tasha Butts fouled with 0.2 seconds left as Eli missed the free throw. And then Butts hit the game-winning basket against Stanford. She's been a hero 2 in a row, trying to get it into Johnson. She's double-teamed. Ball knocked loose. No whistle. Davis. Holy cow. Johnson at the buzzer. And Tennessee somehow has done it again.
tell you what, if you believe in destiny,
this Tennessee,
you got to believe in Tennessee.
Well, you do, and this LSU team said, why not us? And Tamika Johnson gets the ball, and they triple team her, and she loses it. And who would have thought it? But Pat Summitt has just... How do we keep doing it?
She's walking over toward where we're broadcasting, just shaking her head with a smile on her face, a wry smile, like, you know, it's great to win, but I'd like to win by a little more comfortable margin every once in a while.
And I tell you, LSU felt very confident. You could tell from their swagger coming off out of that timeout. This is the last play, but we missed the one before where she turned the ball over and Davis was able to, here it is right here. Here's a triple team. She got caught off balance at time. Ashley Robinson at 6'5", threw her whatever. And you see, really, it was a travel. And it would have been better off as a travel because they could have set up.
Actually would have. And Davis, tremendous defense. Robinson blocked her path. Davis reached in and knocked it away. They got the steal. And Pat Summitt has survived three nail biters in a row. Let's check in with Mark Jones.
LaToya, walk us through the game plan. Were you guys looking to double team off the inbound pass to Johnson?
Yes. The plan was to just double Tamika because she was a quick offensive player. So coach just told us to double Johnson, and once she got the ball in our hands, just contain her, and that's what we did.
What were you thinking when the ball came right to you? Did it feel like forever?
I mean, it did in a way. Because we played a close game, and we just wanted to just execute the last minute of the game, and we did that.
This game was such a struggle, just like the two before. Do you guys feel nearly invincible now in close games, like you're going to win it in the end?
Well, you're right. I mean, we have had close games, and I just feel like we just tried to just do our game plan, and I just feel like we did a great job of doing that.
They're really hurting you with the dribble penetration most of the night. Your three-point shooting wasn't happening for you. What did it for you in the end?
Just playing to my strengths and just doing the little things that I know I could do to help the team. And I just wanted to try to contain Tamika because she's a quick offensive player. And I think I did a really good job of doing that.
All right, LaToya, congratulations, guys. This from a player who now two key games at one time thought about transferring because she wasn't getting a lot of run. Back to you guys.
Well, she's getting it now, Mark. And LaToya Davis provided the moment for our